read about some fucking... this little spazzy looking nerd in Rolling Stone who makes some sort of fucking music with a Macintosh. Which to me, I don't give a fuck. Is not, it is music, but it isn't. You know what I mean? There's just, it's more like you are, it's like you're an editor. I would say it's more like that. Like, I don't think that what you're doing, it's like you are making music, but you're taking sounds and all this shit that you don't have the ability to make. Sacrificing babies before I ever gave him any shit because I have a fanboy crush on him, so I can't really trash him because in my twisted fucking narcissistic world, I think I actually have a chance of meeting him and maybe playing drums on one track on his next album. That's the lofty area my ego lives in. You know what I should do? One of these weeks, I should actually play drums for you guys, or maybe guitar, and you can hear how fucking awful I am. Then you can trash me and feel better about yourselves. Isn't that fun? Doesn't that make you feel good to watch somebody attempt something and then completely fail? And then you get that warm feeling in your chest where you're like, see, that's what happens when you try. That's what happens when you go after your dreams. I knew I was right by choosing this job that was safe rather than fulfilling. Isn't that what you do? You fucking cunts. That one guy, that fat guy who made all those loops for Justin Timberlake and Jay-Z. Who was that guy? Yo, that's hot to death. That guy? I guess that guy is... I saw him. He can actually play instruments and shit. Oh, well, you know what? I'm painting with a broad brush here, people. I'm just saying... I don't know what I was saying. Halfway through that, I fucking got lost in the sugar of cheesecake at 8 in the fucking morning.